aka Mr. Boxer.com, aka Mr. Howl at Your Motherfucking Boy. So I'm here today, man. I'm talking about Danny Garcia versus Shawn Porter. Apparently, the WBC has mandated a fight against these two guys. And this is some more interesting news, a very interesting development by the WBC. Now, this is, you know, I know Shawn Porter would love to fight Danny Garcia. I'm very confident that Danny Garcia, Shawn Porter would want to take that fight. But does Danny Garcia really want to fight Shawn Porter at this particular point in time? I don't know. Yes, Shawn Porter is beatable, but for Danny Garcia's style, I don't know that he would do very well against Shawn Porter. Now, I'm not gonna break this fight down or anything like that, but the work rate of Shawn Porter, the aggressiveness, the ruggedness, the, you know, I don't see him being active enough to be successful versus Shawn Porter, if he doesn't hurt Shawn Porter. Now, I think he could hurt Shawn Porter because, to me, Danny Garcia has very good timing. So he could hurt Shawn Porter coming in and really wobble him, you know what I mean? And if he does that, then that could change the entire landscape of the fight. But I don't know. It could go either way, though, man. It really could, because Shawn Porter has he's proved himself time and time again. That style that he employs, that very active, rugged style, it's very effective. As much as I don't like it, as much as I hate it, it's very effective, especially against guys who have a very, very non-existent work rate. And Danny Garcia's work rate is very much to be desired, okay? The guy, in a lot of cases, throws one punch at a time. And you know, he'll throw little combinations and spots, you know what I mean? And he'll pretty much look for counter punches. And I think the counter punch opportunities will be there versus Shawn Porter. But it's like, if he doesn't hurt Shawn Porter, and Shawn Porter has kind of proven to have a very good chin, if he doesn't hurt Shawn Porter, then I think he's just going to lose the fight, man. He is, because Shawn Porter's just going to be aggressive. He's going to be active. He's going to be all those things in a culmination, you know, bundled together as one, and he's gonna beat you, you know what I mean? If you don't do anything to stop him, he's gonna beat you, you know what I mean? And I don't see Danny Garcia as having the tools to be able to beat someone like a Shawn Porter, okay? To beat Shawn Porter, you have to be skilled enough to be able to, you know, fight him from the outside and maintain different distance and really, really use some fundamental good skills on someone like a Shawn Porter. You're not going to beat him I don't know, man. It's hard to say. It's really hard to say, you know what I mean? The WBC mandating this fight is very interesting. And then on the other end, Errol Spence is more than willing to fight Danny Garcia. So if you're Danny Garcia, do you fight Errol Spence or do you fight Shawn Porter? I mean, it's rough for you on either way. You know what I mean? Either way, you got some rough shit ahead of you. I don't know what you do if you're Danny Garcia. You know what I mean? You go fight Errol Spence. But at least if you fight Errol Spence, that's for a belt. You know what I mean? You have some accolade at the end of the tunnel with Errol Spence as opposed to Shawn Porter. But Errol Spence, of course, to me, is the more dangerous fight than Shawn Porter. Shawn Porter has, there's somewhat of a recipe to beat Shawn Porter. You know what I mean? You could use the Kell Brook method versus Shawn Porter and potentially come out on top. And I think Danny Garcia has, he could possibly utilize that strategy, that Kell Brook method of holding, and I mean that sort of thing, and you know, and catch them up in exchanges and that sort of, I mean, he could do it. I mean, these are very interesting fights, man. You know, boxing is just heating up, man. It's a lot of good shit going on. I don't know. This is very interesting. Like I said, I'm not going to break down the fight in this particular video, but I just wanted to kind of give my thoughts on this. I thought it was very interesting that the WBC mandated this fight. The WBC just seems to be just doing all kind of random shit, man. I really don't know. Like, didn't Shawn Porter just fight a title eliminator versus Andre Berto? So why are they mandating another eliminator with Shawn Porter? Like, what? Let Shawn Porter live. Like, he can fight someone else. Like, let Shawn Porter fight You know what I mean? He, at this point, I'm not mad if Shawn Porter just fought a bum. Like, I wouldn't be mad at that. Let him fight a bum. You know what I mean? It's fine. He doesn't have to fight Danny Garcia. Like, it's cool. You know what I mean? The WBC has been very active, you know what I mean, as far as mandating fights and that sort of thing. So, you know what I mean? You know, the fight in general is very, very interesting. Very interesting. You know what I mean? If it gets made, hey, that's what's up. You know what I mean? But let me know what you guys think. Hit it up in the comment section below. You can also hit me up on Twitter, Box Capital X or Capital X Die. You can hit me up on Facebook, Box Minus Sign or Minus Sign Die. Like the video, subscribe, all that bullshit. But until next time, it's your buddy Dynamite signing out. Holla at your motherfucking boy.